Hello and welcome to Parkside Studios in Birmingham. Tonight, we are reviving the spirit of one of the most fondly remembered British music television shows, Jazz 625, which was broadcast on BBC Two between 1964 and 1966. Our program is called Jazz 1080, reflecting the changes in technology that have occurred since that time. In all other respects, we have followed BBC production processes of the 1960s, and our audience tonight will be treated to the spectacle not just of jazz being played, but also of a multi-camera shoot, recording as live. Tonight's group is led by Xhosa, one of the most inventive and respected saxophonists currently on the Birmingham scene. The band opened with a Dexter Gordon tune called Fried Bananas, and are going to follow it up now with The Nearness of You by Hoagie Carmichael. Xhosa on tenor sax is joined by Lee Griffiths on alto, James Austin on bass, Ewan Palmer on drums, and T. Awala on piano. Tonight on Jazz 1080, the Xhosa Cole Quintet.
Thank you.
So, man. So good to see you right here. What was that song called?
That was Thou Swell by Rodgers and Hart, and it featured Lee Griffiths on the alto and Ewan Palmer on the drums.
Wow. The songs that you're performing tonight, any of them have any deep, meaningful significance to you or anything?
Yeah, I wouldn't say necessarily deep meaning or significance, but I just love them. I just love playing them. I love listening to them. A lot of them are tunes that I've just listened to for ages and ages on repeat. And then finally I've got around to doing some little arrangements and playing with these. You know, it's great to play with these lot and play the tunes I love so much. It's a lot of music of singers and stuff. It's some are Etta Jones stuff, some are Ella Fitzgerald stuff, some are Blossom Dearie. It's all big mix, but mainly singers. I love singers.
Right. There's a lot of passion there.
Yeah.
But how did you kind of decide on who to bring tonight, how to get the band together?
Yeah, well, I think a lot of the times when I'm at gigs myself, going to watch people, there's certain gigs where you're like, oh man, I just want to get the tenor out and play with this. Like, and these guys in various forms and at various like occasions and stuff, I've just been like, man, I really want to play with this person. And it's just been a great opportunity to, you know, get these like together and do some sick tunes.
And when did the the passion start though, man? When did the art start, the music?
I think the passion really started back in Holyhead. We used to have a chap come in called Sid Peacock. We did stuff together for his Surge mm-hmm. Festival earlier in the year. And it was really some of my first experience of like improvising and stuff. And you imagine like these year 7s to 11s just playing free music in school. It's just pretty crazy because it teaches you all the right things about music in terms of how to appreciate it, how to play and how to improvise and how to be free with your instrument, no matter what your facility is on it. And just how to approach it with a creative and playful, childlike approach.
Yeah, childlike, I know that one. And speaking of this, you know, all the Lego that's been put together, what do you think of the new setup in here?
It's mad. Being here, I think it's great because they've just, it's quite a new building, I gather, and all the technology is really like top of the range. And it's just been amazing working with a mixture of the really great people who've been working on these things for years and years, and then to get them with the students, it's just been an amazing opportunity, I think, yeah.
All right, well, I'm getting someone doing a helicopter signal.
Cool.
And continue.
We will.
Love it. What's the next tune?
We're going to feature T on the piano, and we're going to play another tune by Rodgers and Hart called Manhattan. I hope you enjoy.
All right, thank you, man. Cheers. Guess we will. Thank
Cheers.
You. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
That was Crazy He Calls Me by Carl Sigman, featuring James Austin and bass, followed by And Then She Stopped by the great Dizzy Gillespie. Television is a time machine, and this evening we have gone back to the 1960s, an era when jazz defined the cultural project of BBC Two. Our musicians, our crew, and our studio audience have participated in an experiment, one that supposes that by understanding the processes of the past, we might discover the futures of jazz television. Our final tune is Freddie Hubbard's Birdlike. Good night.